Now, like I said, there's one big thing I'm leaving for the last. For now, let me just show you how the payslips get generated. Now, this is a situation where you want something that can be retained on the system as a record of that those payslips you sent out for a particular month. So what I did was, rather than make it necessary for the person to print it out, the person could actually file them electronically by creating image versions of the payslips, kind of like some kind of digital image record. So what I did was to create this button that allows you to take from the first person to the last person on this list, which we know how we added from here, rather than you having to choose them one by one. You can actually do that. You can remove some names if you want. Just click drop menu and choose. But then you want to generate the payslips, and you don't have to do it one after the other, one after the other, spending the whole day. You click a button and it happens. Watch how this thing works. Click the button and watch the screen now. See what happens. Okay, watch that. Can you see that? I deliberately left it. I would have frozen the screen, okay, and display and what you call disable update of your screen. But I wanted you to see how it works. But there's a function to make Excel work faster in execution of code. You can actually stop the updating of the screens, display, make the display of the screen updates to be false. But I left it as true so that you could see the changes the application was making as it was generating reports. Now, it has created image versions, okay, payslips to print in a different workbook. Can you see that? It's just a workbook next to the workbook you created. Now, if I bring it forward, just so you see what I mean, see how it makes life easy for you. It's even set it in a way that you can just define a print range. In fact, ideally, what I normally do in this case is I prepare, let me see if I did that with this. I normally prepare it in such a way that it's ready to print. Let's see. Oh, you see what I mean? You can see the payslips are ready to go. Let me bring them closer. You can see that. You can see maybe there's a bit of a formatting issue because of the image, the graphic. I usually test that before I let it go. But you can see that it's ready to print. So what happens is the guy gets to print out these. These are images, by the way. Let me just show you. See that? It's actually an image. Okay? So, I mean, that's what was created. And it was created by the application within seconds. Imagine you have 150 staff, or maybe, I don't know, 5,000. I've created applications for clients that generated more than 20,000 pages. Just send them, changing a lot of data for an entire national primary healthcare database. The same thing. You create a function, you put in a routine and set a loop, and the whole thing happens. But the thing is, you have to create a structure that makes it worthwhile to know all of that. This is not about demonstrating that you're an expert, a guru in writing code. This is more about adding value, saving time, saving effort, making it possible for people to be more productive in 24 hours. That's what this is about. So I'm not trying to say that those who created their own payslips don't know what they're doing. I'm just trying to say I can add value to you. And you can also learn from me how to add value to others and how to add value to yourself. Okay. Now let me take you to what I call the big one, which it really excites me. It's the one I feel is the ultimate if you're going to use Excel really maximally. And that's, you click the load form button here. This is what I love about this. And what happens is I can choose, for instance, the name of this gentleman, Atiku Abu. I don't know who that is. Just, these are just dummy entries. And you can see it has populated the entire table. Now, look what I've done here. There is a section for deductions. The days in the month are shown. And if the days are, if it checks, if it's a February, then it checks. It adjusts for the number of days. You know, it indicates the number of days the person has. It allows you to indicate the number of days the person worked. You know, the basic salary, all of that. Then it writes it in words as well. This is actually a function that does this in words. So if I were to, for instance, make some changes, let me make some changes. So make some changes, I click this edit record. It asks me if I want to unlock the form field so I can make changes, and I say yes. When I do yes, I can now come here and say, okay, this guy now earns maybe 60,000 here. Okay, did you notice the change? I'm going to take it back. If I remove this and make it 50,000, can you see? It shows 53,795. If I now add the 60,000, watch, 190. Can you see that? You don't have to go to the spreadsheet to see, but just for me to show you. Let's go. Look, this is a modeless form, so I can actually access the worksheet from behind. But you can see the changes. You can see that the net salary 109,838. Let's watch as we make another change again. Let's change this to 20,000 housing allowance. Okay, you see the adjustment, 72,000. Can you see that? 72,000. Now this is the beauty of it. You can again, because I want the form to make it possible to stay in one place and do everything. Look what I've done here. You can even change the units, the currency. I can make this to be naira. You see that? And it accepts me, and I say kobo. If there's an entry for the smaller units, it puts kobo. You see? That is how. I mean, think about it. You would have had to go to the settings worksheet and then come here to make the change to the currency. Come on, why do you want to do that when you can stay on one form and do everything? And you can even look, you can delete a record, you can create a new record, you can do anything you want to do. You know, you can type, do you want to stop here? Because I could go on and on and on, but I'm sure you get the message. The point I'm making is, from the simplistic interface these guys had in there, as this gentleman in India, what I created is this little application. I did this just within about, I think, 4 hours. You know, I just built this many years ago now, probably about 4 or 5 years ago. And like, 2012, probably, yeah. I'm not sure now. It's been a while. I can't remember when I do. I do some of these things because I just feel, wow, I just want to let off steam. But it occurred to me that I should begin to show this in videos so people can really visualize what's possible. I don't have any certification in Microsoft. I don't know what they call it, professional or whatever. But I've been doing this for over 20 years. You know, and I do this for clients who pay me well. And I now sell my software. I actually do more of selling of my software than building for clients. I work remotely for clients in and out of Africa. And I offer you this. The opportunity to learn from me privately, confidentially, how to do these things you just see me do for payslips. If you want to generate payslips the way I do, you want to be able to do it for your clients, you want to have your own application you sell to your clients or whatever, get across to me. I can help you. I can make things happen for you. I can make you look like a superstar in your company, like I was when I was in Guinness. The records are there, they cannot be changed. I still have proof of a lot of the record results I got, and I offer you that opportunity to do what I did and even more, okay, and boost your productivity. Get in touch with me, www.tayoslagbade.com. That's my website address, tayoslagbade.com, or email me at tayosola.com, or better still, go to excelheaven.biz, excelheaven.biz. Go there and you will see the description of the steps you need to take to get across to me, to join my inner circle and learn this from me. Okay, that is the only channel through which you can learn this from me. Well, if you are interested in paying a lot more than you should, you can ask me to tell you how to get it outside of being a member of my inner circle. There's always a way, and I never say never. So please get in touch. I wish you well.